from beautiful Marcus Square Arena in the capital city of Indianapolis, Indiana. It's Hoosier Championship time tonight, and we've got a dandy all lined up for you. It may be a little different in character than some of you might have thought earlier today, but two brilliant basketball teams will go at it here in just a few minutes. And of course, in the upper bracket, it'll be Kokomo, a 73-70 victor over Floyd Central in a game that seesawed in the latter stages. And then next game, it was won by Lawrence North over South Bend St. Joe. And quite a surprise, that final score was 81-62, with Lawrence North brilliantly pulling away in the latter stages of the ball game. As Eric Montross and also a lad from Todd Leary by the name of Lawrence North, well, he did a beautiful job for his basketball team here this afternoon. Tonight, it will be again. It'll be Kokomo against Lawrence North, and we'll be introducing some special guests and some outstanding young people in just a few moments. Stay with us. The brilliant coach of Kokomo was standing right here with me about 1983. That's right. I was getting it out. Basil, congratulations.
Well, we feel really great. The Heinemans were back today from talk to our kids a little bit, and that was a great thrill with Connersville that year, and we're certainly hoping to bring it home for Kokomo this year.
Basil, you have an unusual task here tonight. You're going against one of the great big men of all time already in Indiana high school basketball, Eric Montross.
Well, we're going to have to do a good job on Eric. He's just playing very well. He's asserting himself both offensively, defensively, and probably his biggest strength has been his rebounding. So we're going to have to play a good job defensively, helping out inside on him. But, you know, we got a 6'7 and a 6'8 center, and we'll be able to do a good job defending him.
What about they have an awfully good outside scorer, too, a lad with great speed.
Todd Leary does a nice job outside, and also Todd Richards is a three-year starter for him. So they have three players that have been through the wars for him. Then they have Bush, who's kind of a role player, and Watts, who's playing very well. So it's a team effort that got Lawrence North here.
Basil, your offense frequently utilizes the weak side. You go from one side to the other in a hurry, and they make a pick inside. That could be effective here tonight.
Well, we certainly hope so. We hope we can use our center to do some screening and hopefully do some things with him. But they do a great job defensively. Jack has done a great job defensively throughout his career, and we're going to have to really do a good job setting screens and being patient tonight.
You still think your team, this one looks a lot like the Connersville team you won with in 83?
Very similar. A lot of heart, great leadership in the guard. We had the Heinemans in. Brian Reeves now has got as much heart as any kid I've ever coached, and one of the best point guards I've ever coached. So we hope that those kids will be able to carry it through, and they've worked hard for it.
Your team not in perfect shape, I understand.
We've got a couple injuries, you know. Matt Johnson went down with a sprained ankle, but came back and played very well in the morning game. But he looks a little tight right now, so I haven't talked to him yet. But I'm sure he'll go the best he can.
Oh, well, congratulations on getting to this far, and have a good ball game tonight. Well,
thank you very much, and we appreciate all your coverage.
Thank you very much. Let's call in Jack Kiefer now. Here is a coach who did an absolutely magnificent job here this afternoon against a ball club I'm sure was favored in the contest this afternoon. Jack Kiefer, congratulations, Lawrence North.
Well, thank you. I hope we can play similar to that today. The kids just in that fourth quarter, I think they scored 30-plus points or something.
That's right.
They just did a good job, and I felt like I outlasted them a little bit. It's kind of a gutty game down toward the end there, and our legs might have been a little stronger maybe.
Well, you certainly pulled away when you had to in the final period.
Oh, dear. Somebody told me it was 19 points.
That's right. Well, it was very close at the end of three quarters.
It seemed like it was a very close game to me.
Let's talk a little bit about the action here. You have outside shooting. You also have some pretty good speed. You had a lad with 28 points here this afternoon, and Eric, of course, at center. Are we going to see a different offense?
No. You'll see hit Montross as much as we possibly can. And Leary's play comes off Montross's play. He first gets you thinking Montross, and then all of a sudden he pops up on you. And that's just there's no sense wasting that 7-footer. There's only a couple of those in the nation, I think.
I remember when you coached at Oak Hill, you had quite a basketball player by the name of Monty Tao, one of the greatest little men I ever saw, and I understand you still stay in touch with him.
Oh, Monty's in Florida right now. I helped coach him. Galen Smith was the head coach at Oak Hill then, and I was his assistant. Monty was as good a competitor as I probably ever coached, and some of these kids remind me of him, really.
Well, your coaching here was distinctive this afternoon. Eric is incredibly strong and moves very well for a lad only a junior. Will you use him like you did this afternoon?
I'll use him more if I can. And we try, our first job down the floor is simply to find him. And if we can find him, we get to him. If we can't, you'll notice he's probably one of our better passers on the ball club. So if he's triple teamed or you drop your man in on him, he does a nice job of getting it right back out to you.
Final question, what is the key we can watch for here tonight?
Oh, I think the key is that we step the tempo up a little bit. Basil's guilty of playing that crazy four corner for about 10 minutes a game if you let him. So, and we're not about to go out and chase him all around there, but we just simply want to get ahead so he can't really do it.
Well, this is a moment of history for you and for Lawrence North. Congratulations on a fine year.
Okay, thank you.
Jack Kiefer, the coach of Lawrence North, and that's our preview. Tom Heshen and Jerry Baker will be back in just a few moments. We'll be doing coverage of the championship game and stay here at Marcus Square Arena. Don't go away. Hilliard Gates saying goodbye for a moment.
And the lights of Market Square Arena silhouette the downtown skyline as we get set for the championship game of the Indiana Boys State High School Basketball Tournament. The 17,490 who were jammed inside for a pair of games earlier today have returned to watch the Wildcats of Kokomo High place their 25-5 mark on the line against the Wildcats of Lawrence North, the 24-4. And to the winner, of course, goes the spoils, the crown of king of high school basketball in Hoosier Land. And hello again, everybody. Jerry Baker, along with Hilliard Gates and Tom Heshen, we welcome you to Market Square Arena for tonight's championship basketball game. In case you were not with us earlier today, it was Kokomo, a winner over Floyd Central, 73-70. But Kokomo did it the hard way. They let a 17-point lead get away. They fell behind, came roaring back and won it by that three-point differential. One of the keys to the victory was Brad Seabury, their junior forward, who finished up with 22 points and really played an outstanding basketball game. Basil Mauby is the head coach of this ball club. We mentioned earlier today, we'll mention it again tonight. That may be one of the keys. Basil won a state championship at Connersville, and that is a strong plus. Game two was not much of a contest. Lawrence North's Wildcats played about as good as a high school basketball team can play in rolling over South Bend St. Joe, 81-62. That St. Joe ball club, number one in the state throughout most of the year, number two at the end of the year. 17-0 at the end of the first quarter, then the explosion occurred behind Eric Montross. The big guy had a total of 21 points and 19 rebounds, but he was not by himself because Todd Leary chipped in with 28 points and 8 rebounds. They forget about Leary a lot of times. They better not do it tonight. It is Lawrence North and Kokomo for the State High School Basketball Championship on the IHSAA Television Network.
Lawrence North Wildcats come into this ball game with 24 victories, 4 defeats. Kokomo Wildcats at 25-5. Two great basketball squads. We are about to get set for what has become a very expected, if you will, circumstance, the great presentation of the colors and the playing of our national anthem. Let's go across to Scott Gray.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, Fort Wayne Northside High School is proud to present tonight's pregame ceremonies featuring the Northside Color Guard, men's vocal quartet, and drum majors. Fort Wayne Northside's Color Guard has earned many honors, including a performance with the Hooks Indiana All-State Marching Band at the Indianapolis 500 Parade. This summer, the Color Guard will join with the Marching Band and the Swing Choir to perform in Japan. The Color Guard is under the direction of Larry Kenner, with drill design by Ken Joyce. The band director is Edward King II. The men's vocal quartet is under the direction of Betty McKee. And now for your pregame enjoyment and singing of the national anthem, we are proud to present the Northside High School Color Guard men's vocal quartet and drum majors.
Thank you. was so proudly hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets red glare, the bombs bursting in air, they knew through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and our home our God.
The Fort Wayne Northside High School color guard, men's vocal quartet, and drum majors. All the preliminary leading up to the state basketball championship. Now, let's pause for this from one of your network sponsors, Farm Bureau Insurance. That is your matchup, Lawrence North, Kokomo. Kokomo's been here before. Lawrence North, first time ever. From left to right on your screen, Hilliard Gates, Tom Heschen, and Jerry Baker. It's time to meet tonight's participants. Let's go across the floor again to Scott Gregg. Scott?
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. And starting lineups for tonight's championship game. First for the visiting Lawrence North Wildcats. Number 10, Carl Rainey. Number 22, DeJuan Lewis. Number 33, James Long. Number 35, Keith Berryhill. And your starting lineup for the Wildcats at one guard, a 5'11" junior, number 13, Damon Watts. The other guard, a 5'10" senior, number 20, Todd Richard. At forward, a 6'3" senior, number 30, Todd Leary. The other forward, a 6'2" senior, number 45, Victor Bush. The center, 7' junior, number 53, Eric Montross. And the head coach of the 24-4 Wildcats, Jack Kiefer. Number 20, Art Murrell. 25-5, Wildcats of Kokomo, Basil Mauby.
And the officials for the championship game on the left, Steve Fisher from Ligoti and Gary Leisner from Dubois on the right.
We'll be back with the opening kickoff in just a moment. Now this from one of your network sponsors, Indiana Bell. Tom Eschen, both these ball clubs have been hit with an injury bug here tonight.
Well, Kokomo especially hurt. They have one of the starters not in the lineup. I think he can play. That's Matt Johnson, who turned an ankle. But more importantly, off the bench, Keith Gaylord looks very problematical that he will not get in. He has a knee injury from this afternoon.
He came out, warmed up, but not for very long, nor for very much, as a matter of fact. They've taken Matt Johnson out of the starting lineup at Kokomo at guard and replaced him with Demondo Fowler, who's a 5'9 sophomore, so they don't gain any height there for sure because Johnson was 6 feet tall. Into the big guy in the middle, puts it back outside. Here is Richards. He got nailed. No foul, and he got the hoop.
Well, there it is going inside, and the defense collapses, and the open man, and they have to hit it, and Todd Richards started it off for Lawrence North.
Well, this Lawrence North ball club will come right at you. As soon as they throw the ball in the air, they're going to get right in your face. Good, strong effort that time, but a turnover on the movement inside that time by Brian Reeves of Kokomo.
Well, you see that the Wildcats of Kokomo are going to try and clear that middle and give Reeves an opportunity to penetrate. We've got a couple of Wildcat teams here tonight.
One with a K and one with a C. Kokomo spells its name W-I-L-D-K-A-T-S, and the Lawrence North ball club uses the C. 2-0 basketball game. Lawrence North with the basketball, wearing the traveling green uniforms. Here's the big guy. Eric Montross. Montross had a sensational afternoon game in Lawrence North's victory over South Bend St. Joseph's, 81-62. He was 10 of 17 from the field, 1 of 4 from the free throw line, and he pulled down 19 rebounds to go along with 21 points. So it's a 4-0 ball game with Lawrence North quickly out in front.
Well, the Wildcats of Kokomo, there's a shot over Montross by Galloway, partially blocked. North back with a possession.
That was Leary who came out of there with it. Richards in the middle, and heavy traffic there at a personal foul called against Kokomo. It'll be on number 34 of the Wildcats, Brad Seabree. Boy, if Seabree has the kind of a game tonight, Tom, that he had earlier today, he's going to be a real force to be reckoned with.
Well, he's going to have that kind of a game to pick up a little bit of the slack. He was in the lane there trying to keep Victor Bush from getting in position to receive the pass and was whistled for the foul.
Kokomo hasn't had a real good shot yet.
Leary will inbounds to Montross. Eric gets the shot away and scores. Eric was at.
I think we just got to play our hearts out, play the way we can, play defense the way we can, and demand the ball inside and shoot the eyes out of the outside. We're going to be state champion.
Kokomo got the ball to the baseline. That is Seabree, the young man that Tom and I just spoke of. He had a sensational ball game earlier today, hitting 10 of 13 from the field in that Kokomo Wildcats win over Floyd Central.
Well, Kokomo's defense, certainly their strong point, and they forced a turnover right there as Leary tried to beat it with the dribble at full court press. And we're going to see the situation here where he tries to go between Seabree and Reeves, and he's called for taking steps. Kokomo possession.
Brad Reeves with the basketball, moving right side. He's working with Bondo Fowler with the guard spot. Reeves puts up what would have been an air ball, but he caught the back one. That's about it. Good effort on the floor that time by Victor Bush. Out it comes to Leary on the near side. 5:55 to go. Leary's got the three in the air. Rims comes up. Rebound taken down by Montross, but a foul, and it's going to be against Kokomo again. We'll wait for the guilty party to be signified by the official here tonight.
Another illustration of the fact that when you get the ball on the board, you've got a great opportunity with Montross in there. Reeves is whistled for the foul.
Number one on him and number two against the ball club. Well, we talked about it in our earlier telecast of the game today, but even when he's not scoring, Tom Hetchin, Montross makes things happen. That time it was not good for his ball club. Reeves missing, got his own rebound, put it back up, and it goes in. It's not going to count, though.
Here we see Montross having the pass attempt blocked away by Galloway, who really started it all. And then Brian Reeves is going to take it as far as he can. He goes up for the shot. Gets his own rebound in the lane, and Montross found himself in a bad spot.
Here is Reeves. Good penetration that time against Richards, and Reeves picks up his first couple of points. And a It's a 6-4 basketball game. After being down 6-0, Kokomo has come back with back-to-back coach by Brad Seabury and Brian Reeves to get to within two. They have yet to lead in this contest with 5:25 to play in the opening period. All the marbles and boys high school basketball in the state of Indiana. Richards. Bill Montross and three white shirts come after him. He got the turnaround baseline shot anyway.
There's no way Bob Galloway, even though he's 6'8", is going to get to that ball the way Montross releases it. And he's really shooting well.
Speaking of Galloway, he's had the catch of almost reached the goal they set at the start of the season this year.
Going last off because we had practice at midnight on the 17th of October. And, you know, we wanted to come out and we wanted to win it because, you know, we came so close last year and we felt that we had, you know, even with losing our two, you know, good seniors, that we had more talent than we had last year.
The tip off, I believe, they did it to Galloway. It will be Galloway's first 2 points of the contest on the outside shot taken that time. That caught the rim and came right back out. Now here moves the move down the lane that time by Leary. And the pass. Like the first game today.
Well, Leary is one of the finest performers we've seen in a long while, taking the ball to the basket. Great determination. He's going to get the shot off. Gets it on the board nicely. And he has drawn the foul right here. He's going to have an opportunity to complete a three-point play as the Wildcats have Mark Merle in the lineup, a six-foot junior. I should say the Kokomo Wildcats.
Galloway with his first personal foul. And a three-point play by Leary.
Mark Smith has replaced Galloway, Jerry.
We saw a lot of changes earlier today in all four teams' lineups. It is a hot day in the city. Temperature reached in excess of 70 degrees. Very unusual for this time of the year. And it was really hot at Market Square Arena. Lawrence North of the 24-4 mark has Damon Watts and Todd Richards at guard. They tried to go into Montross in the middle. They lost it away. And it's picked up by the Kokomo Wildcats. In a hurry, they come to the other end. Nothing doing, and the rebound pulled on by Lawrence North again. You only get one shot, and if you don't hit it, you better do something in a hurry on defense. Here's the steal by Brian Reeves, one on two, and a great move, but it rolls off the rim, and the follow-up is good by Mark Merle. Mark didn't even play in the afternoon game.
It's an indication of a team. Here goes Richards for the hoop.
Blocking foul called against Kokomo. When you make a hoop, you best not spend a whole lot of time celebrating because Lawrence North likes to get right back up the floor in a hurry. The foul is on number 50, Mark Smith. That's number one on him. And the fourth against the ball club.
Well, this is Brian Reeves going to the West basket, and the ball won't fall for him, but good follow by Mark Merle. Then we go quickly to the other end as Todd Richards took it to the basket and drew the foul from Mark Smith. I really did not think the pace would be this quick here in the first quarter.
I'm a little surprised also, Tom, because both ball clubs, even though the scores might not have indicated that, although Kokomo won by only three, they were tight ball games and they were up and down the floor.
Well, as Jack Kiefer mentioned to Hilliard, he does not want to get behind in the ball game and let Kokomo hold the basketball. So as long as they're behind, which they are now by four, they're going to have to maintain a good offensive posture.
And Richards now with 4 points of this contest. And yes, he does go hard. He is like a water bug. He's all over the floor out there, but he plays the entire 32 minutes in that same fashion. Kokomo's Johnson's got it now. He did not start in tonight's ball game. There's a whistle away from the ball. They're pointing to Victor Bush down inside.
Yeah, Johnson came in to replace Merle. He is a starter that sprained an ankle rather badly this afternoon. Came back in after the injury occurred. Did not start tonight, but in the contest now.
Clock showing 3 minutes and 5 seconds to play in the opening quarter. Rebound pulled on by Damon Watts of Lawrence North. Intercepted up court though by Brian Reeves. He's had an impressive first quarter of play. Fires some long range, misses. Rebounds deep on the right side by Seabury. Triple team, ball stripped away from him, and Damon Watts comes out of the traffic with it. Watts, a 5'11 junior starting guard. He's not much of a scorer, though he did have 13 points in the afternoon game today. Now the ball is batted free and last touched by Lawrence North and along to Kokomo.
There, we almost had a volleyball game here on the half court.
Timeout will be taken with the clock showing 2 minutes and 38 seconds to play in the opening quarter. It is a lead by Lawrence North of 12-8 over the Wildcats of Kokomo. Now this from one of your network sponsors, American Dairy Association of Indiana.
1989.
Todd Leary has 3 points in the ball game. Earlier today, he shot 10 of 24. He says he hopes to shoot better tonight.
Shoot better than I did today. I didn't think I hit very well today. I had some open shots that I missed, so maybe tonight I'll work it around a little more and get the wide open shot.
Todd Leary, mad a few words, but a lot of action on the court. 2:38 to play in this first quarter.
We had some Kokomo fans that were down here in the city today that didn't see the morning contest that were able to get tickets because this bunch is loaded in here tonight with Kokomo people.
Yeah, they have. In fact, all four of the schools had a terrible time dispensing the tickets because everybody wanted some and there just were not enough to go around. Just inside the three-point arc, shot is off the mark by Reeves and taken down by Lawrence North. The Wildcats with the basketball and the lead at 12-8. Their biggest lead has been 6. Kokomo's never led in this game. 3. That time Montross out of position. The rebound came long to the near side to Matt Johnson. And Johnson didn't start, but they didn't waste much time getting him in the ball game. That's for sure. Here is Smith, and he got the layup.
Well, they went inside with their offense that time, which is pretty difficult to do against Montross, but Mark Smith did a nice job of taking a dribble into the lane and got it away from the big man.
1:44 to play in this first period. 12-10, they're taking that 6-point lead and chopped it down to 2. Now, they had done that earlier, then watched it slide back up to 4 again. And Kokomo on defense now trying to really converge on the big guy. Here's the 3 by Leary. This time it's no good. Montross does what he does so well. Just bat it, keep it alive, and threw it away.
Well, he thought he saw Leary in the corner, and Leary was making a move up the baseline.
Kokomo will have the final minute 24 here in the first quarter. They need some scoring out of Seabury. He says the key to his ball game is hitting that jump.
It's important for me to hit my jumper because if they don't, you know, they lay off, then they cut off my drive. So if I hit my jumper and then, they have to play up on me, then I can take my drive. Then that makes me, two-dimensional. I could drive or shoot from outside.
Seems like Reeves has had his hands on that basketball throughout almost the entire first quarter for the Kokomo Wildcats. They move Smith out at long range now, and Montross is not having any of that. Seabury right there. Now to Baker. First time he's really touched the ball. First time he's had a shot.
Well, there's a key for Kokomo to get Eric Baker in the offense. He did not have a particularly good afternoon, and that's his first basket here this evening.
It's also the first tie of the ball game at 12. It was 6-0 to start out the ball game. Here's the reach-in foul. And that is Reeves going down to help out. That is number 2 on Bryant. And Hilliard, just like we saw earlier today when Lawrence North came away with that victory over South Bend St. Joe, they're going to have to double down on the big guy, Eric Montross.
Well, there was no question about it. And Basil Mombi in the interview before the game said exactly what they were going to do. They had to crowd him and keep him neutralized as much as possible. Kokomo's getting good shots, but they're not dropping for him. They're hurrying him.
We have seen teams this year, Tom Hedges, try to play Eric Montross straight up, but it just can't be done.
No, although that time I think he was far enough away. You really don't need to get back too far on him. He's not that dangerous at that point. With 2 fouls on Brian Reeves, he's gone to the bench, and Mark Burrell has come in. And we also have a change in the North lineup. But Carl Rainey is in. Going to give Todd Richards a little break. I think that may have coincided with the Reeves move because Richards was guarding Reeves.
Montross was 1-for-4. If there was a deficiency in his game earlier today, that would have been it. He was 1-for-4 from the free throw stripe, but 10 of 17 from the floor. Yes, so far in tonight's game, 7 points. Montross now with 8. His average is 21-4. He had 21. He has 64 blocked shots on the year. And he added 3 to that total in the afternoon victory today. This is the second game for both these clubs tonight for the championship. And it can be a tough day on you.
Well, Kokomo positioning himself here maybe for a final shot. We got a 5 count. Closely guarded. Rainey right up on Murrow, and that turns it over. And I know that cannot be very pleasant for the Kokomo ball club to have an opportunity there to tie it at the end of the quarter and not get a shot.
23 seconds to go in this first quarter. Here are the turnovers on your screen. You see that Lawrence North has turned the ball over 8 times, but they still have the lead. They'll do that, though, Tom, once in a while. They don't play out of control. They just play an up-tempo brand of basketball. Eric.
Yeah. Montross's fourth field goal, 10th point of the period. 2 seconds, one. It's good if it goes. It's off the mark, and that's the end of the first quarter of play. For the Boys State High School Basketball Championship in Indiana, after one, Lawrence North leads Kokomo 16-12. Now let's pause for this from one of your network sponsors, Farm Bureau Insurance. In the games we've seen earlier this year, the Wildcats of Lawrence North go right at you. Damon Watts said after this afternoon's victory, that's exactly what they intend to do tonight.
We got to just keep doing what we've been doing. Our defense is our strength, I believe. They think that our inside game is our strength. But we believe it's our defense, so we're going to go out and play it even harder. Not softer. We're going to play it harder, attack, and just do the things we need to do.
There's a great example of it. Leary made the steal, got the 15-footer, and got the hoop. Well, it's a perfect example by Damon Watts of exactly what we're talking about.
That's true, and we do have Keith Gaylord in the ballgame for Kokomo, and that pass was intended for him, and I don't think he can move well enough to come at it forcefully enough.
Interesting. In the first quarter, Kokomo scored 12 points. Six players each had two. Only three players scored for the Lawrence North Wildcats. 10 from Montross, who picked out that steal there. And Todd Richards had three, and Todd Leary had the other one. So 14-12, Lawrence North after the first quarter of play.
Yeah, that's terrific hands to block that shot and control the ball, as Montross did that time.
A loose ball on the floor, picked up by Kokomo. Out of the heavy traffic, Eric Baker. Lawrence North is the first Marion County team to ever reach the Final Four. Tapped up and good by Baker. Eric on a super play to avoid the offensive basket interference and still get the hoop.
Eric is a fine jumper, and I'm really surprised that he hasn't been a little more effective offensively today, but he really hasn't had many shots.
18-14, Lawrence North up by 4 points again. They've never trailed in this contest. They've been ahead by as many as six. Leary loves that shot right at about quarter court on either side, just outside the three-point mark. They had Rainey all by himself. He changes his mind. Now that's where he got.
They have him around the perimeter. Leary on the left, and Watts and Rainey. There's the shot from the corner by Leary.
Pulled out inside by Victor Bush. It's up and it's good, and a foul is called.
Hey, Victor's just a tough kid, and he fought that one off. Look at the statistics. Kokomo had nine more shots than Lawrence North did in the first quarter. North more effective at the free throw line, obviously. And you see the rebounds a little in favor of North. They turned it over more also. And Victor Bush is going to be at the strike.
Fouls on Gotaway, number two. On the line on him.
Number 20, Todd Richards in the lineup.
Richards coming back into the ballgame now. He won't sit down very much in the contest, that I can assure you. And Victor Bush goes to the line. Victor's been in double figures in seven games this year with a high of 16 against Rebuff in regular season play. And he gets the shooter's roll. Bush now has 3 points. Now we'll make a change again. Seth Burnell will come in for Lawrence North. And they will let Victor Bush get arrested. That's the biggest lead of the ball game. 7 points now for Lawrence North's Wildcats. But I don't think, Tom, that Kokomo can ill afford to let Lawrence North get a whole lot more breathing room.
No, they really can't. And Lawrence North has probably a little more quality performers coming off the bench than does Kokomo, particularly with Kokomo's injury situation tonight.
Well, they've seen any action yet. And even Carl Rainey, they don't lose a great deal. They may lose a little scoring punch, but they still have good action on the floor. Kind of tossed up for grabs that time by Brad Sebring. And a foul right at midcourt. And it's taken right in the neck and in the face by Todd Richards. Hilliard?
Well, that's a third foul on Brian Reeves. As Richards, he got him over the left eye, but Richards, a tough kid, he's going to stay in there.
Richards is tough. He's a football quarterback at Lawrence North High School, but he's going to Western Michigan as a wide receiver for their football squad. So he's going to get banged around like that several times his college career.
Kokomo's leader, Brian Reeves, has gone to the bench now with his third foul as Matt Johnson is back in. They have Baker, Sebring, Johnson, and Gaylord in there, along with the man in the middle, Bob Galloway.
Richards gets the roll. They cannot afford to have Brian Reeves on the bench very long. I'd be interested to see how long they leave him over there, because he was the guy that had 15 points, dished out seven assists in the afternoon victory. And he's kind of the key to the ball club. He's handled the ball most of the first quarter.
He runs the offense.
Richards got them both.
Well, his vision wasn't hampered at all. He seemed to be right up there in pop two. He's a little tough kid.
Well, he has 5 points now. They tried to double that time. Leary came over to help out. He let his man free, and it cost him. That's Gaylord.
Leonard gets the three, and that was Leary's man. Now they turn the ball over with a travel violation. They tried to double up that time, and it burned, and then they turned the ball back over on the inbounds play. So with 5 minutes and 39 seconds to play in the game, it's 23-17. Lawrence North leads Kokomo High.
Well, there's a ball back across the timeline. They threw it to Gaylord in the backcourt, and Johnson had not come back into the backcourt before the pass reached him. Gaylord playing on a very gimpy knee. He took a knee to his knee in a little collision this afternoon, and they weren't sure he's going to be able to play at all tonight.
But we had two or three of the minor type injuries in the games today. These guys are tough, though. We played two games in one day, though. It's a tough way to go.
Well, the Kokomo crowd thought that Damon Watts had taken steps, and he might have. No whistle.
Oops, they left Watts by himself. He knocked it home.
Well, they've got those three on the perimeter. Watts, Richards, and Leary. With Gurnell in there now, along with Montross playing low. And a lot of opportunities for them to shoot from the perimeter.
North is not a bashful team about taking the perimeter shot. They'll set up and work for it. Todd points out they'll put three guys out there if they want to. They have no fear. Leary, good second effort that time, reaching right up over the back of Brad Seavey without fouling him. He comes out with a rebound. 8-point lead, biggest lead of the game, 25-17. 4.5 minutes to go here in this first half. Gurnell.
Well, North is running on all cylinders today.
I told somebody before tonight's game, Tom, that I don't know if I've ever seen a more efficient high school basketball team than we saw today when they came away with that victory over South Bend St. Joseph's. Kokomo knocks down from outside. Keith Gaylor. He has back-to-back field goals and 5 points. But they just, when they get it going, they're just as smooth as they can be. And of course, a guy like Montross will help you cover up some deficiencies on your offense and your defense. Knocked out of bounds by Mark Smith. He'll inbounds across the way here at Market Square Arena. Another capacity crowd of 17-5. We're in that vicinity. Here's Eric.
Substitution number 35, Keith
Berryhill. Yeah, Berryhill is going to replace Todd Richards. There's Berryhill, number 35.
Saw limited action earlier today and scored 5 points. 3 minutes and 55 seconds to go in this first half. 27-19, Lawrence North, held ball. The arrow points toward Lawrence North. They'll maintain possession.
Good shot we had right there of the offense. There's the possession arrow. We can see Montross on one side of the lane, Gurnell on the other, and the three men outside. Here comes the inbounds pass. Now let's take a look where they are. There's the three.
Leary off the mark and long. Chased down to the corner and saved down there by Kokomo. Pulled in by Eric Baker. Up on the other side in a hurry, Sebring. He has not been able to penetrate like he did earlier today in that victory over Floyd Central. Now he does. There's the penetration over Montross. That's just what we were talking about.
Well, he was not intimidated. He took it right up to Montross and shot it right over his outstretched hands.
Montross directly in front of our television vantage point. Here's Watts. He goes right back the other way and used the left hand this time. And David Watts has scored 6 points. They've all come here in the second period after he got shut out in the opening 8 minutes. He goes back to eight again, 29-21, with 3:05 to play in the half.
In a 1-3-1 half-court zone by Lawrence North. And it's a good thing Gaylord got off that bench for Kokomo because he's dynamite outside.
Well, he may not be at full steam, but you don't need a lot of angle, apparently, Tom, to shoot the shots. He is 7 points to his credit. They've all come here in the second period after Basil Mulvey decided to put him in and go and see what could happen there. Knock three, whistle foul.
That'll be on Baker. As Montross again draws the crowd, and he tried to get the outlet pass, and Baker got him. We're going to see the big man inside here. There he is looking for the ball. Mark Smith behind him, and Baker comes out front. Now Montross knows he's going to have to get rid of the ball, and Baker knocks his arm away from it. Bush back in for Lawrence North.
53, Eric Montross.
Big Eric goes to the free throw stripe. Well, this guy's going to be one of the most recruited high school seniors in the country next year. Montross is 68% free throw percentage. He'll be coming from everywhere after him, Hilliard.
You think they might sign him early just to avoid all that?
If I were him, I certainly would, I'll guarantee you. He has 12 points. First points here in the second period. Look at the Montross family across the way. They're really have advanced. In fact, that sweater that Dad Montross is wearing has been around for quite some time. 2 minutes and 45 seconds to play in the half. 31-23, Lawrence North over Kokomo. Now this from one of your network sponsors, Indiana Bell. Seb Grinnell, 6'5", senior, coming off the bench for the Lawrence North Wildcats. Says he's not surprised this ball club has come this far.
Before the season started, I figured that we would go to state because I don't see how we couldn't with a 7-footer and a guy that could just kill 3-pointers at will. I couldn't see us not going to the championship.
Basket at the other end by Keith Gaylor. Well, Sam might have felt confident, but I'm sure that Jack Keeper was not quite that confident. He thought the ball club last year was the one that might get him this far. They didn't get out of the sectional last year.
Actually, both of these clubs last year thought they might be here, Kokomo included. There's a pass that got away from Bush. Nice pass right there.
Well, Bush was looking at the basket and not the ball.
Damon Watts coming back for Barry Hill.
Well, we're getting a lot of substitutions in this game, especially in the Lawrence North area down there. They continue to move Watson, Richards, and Bush in and out of the lineup. Rainey has played. Barry Hill, Gurnell. Here your field goal percentages at this point of the game with 2 minutes and 10 seconds to play in the first half. Kokomo not shooting well at all. Oh, all by himself inside. Nobody covered up Brad Seabury, and Brad now has a half a dozen. Four-court pressure still being employed by Kokomo. Their defense has been a factor all year long. They've held opponents under 39% field goal shooting and under 49 points per game.
Kokomo, the type of ball club, but will not get out of their structure. They're going to play the defense. They're going to do the offensive things well, even though the shots may not fall. But they're going to hang tough.
Well, you're shooting less than 40%, and you're only down by four to a ball club shooting 70%, and down with Montross on their side. You're not in bad shape. Eric getting his first bucket of the second 8-minute session now has 14 points. He's just 7.5 points shy of a scoring average.
Could he skip college ball and go right to pro?
It's happened before, Hilliard. I don't think they got that in mind for him, though.
Gaylord almost had another one down.
Gaylord had it in and out of the hoop. Here is Leary going in on Gaylord. Can't get it. Rebound, football, hell ball. It goes the other way this time, and Kokomo will have possession. This for the Kokomo Wildcats is their seventh appearance in the Final Four and their fifth trip to the Final Two.
Well, Leary's shot goes off the rim, and you see the hell ball situation. Two strong kids in there, Seabury and Victor Bush.
Field goals. Kokomo has now scored 5 in a row.
Nice move by Baker.
Can't get the roll. The rebound comes off of the near side. Lost and retained, though, by Damon Watts.
Under a minute now.
33-27, a half a dozen point lead. It's been as high as 10 for Lawrence North. Kokomo has yet to see the top side of the scoreboard so far in this contest. Runner-up medals will be presented at halftime. We'll show that to you. Floyd Central's team will be here. And South Bend St. Joseph's will be here also. So if you're a fan of either of those clubs, stick around. Leary, in his favorite spot, gets an inside, and three shirts come after Montross. It's kicked away and last touched by one of the Kokomo players. So they will inbounds beneath their own hoop.
Well, 27 seconds remaining in this first half. And North up by 6. Let's see what kind of shot they look for.
Richards, Watts, here's Leary. He might be the guy they want to take it if they can't get the ball inside to Eric.
Well, they're not a team that really particularly waits for the final shot. They're going to take it when they get it.
15, you're right, there it is. That's the three, and that's what we were looking for. Todd Leary. Leary now with a half a dozen points. 6'3", senior, averaging 20 per. We're down to the final 4. 3, it's good if it goes. It's off the rim. Montross pulls out another rebound, and we played the halftime. It is a game that has been up and down and over and around. But it's all Lawrence North at this point of the game. They're up by 9, 36-27 at the midway point. Now this from one of your network sponsors, American Dairy Association of Indiana. Halftime score here at Market Square Arena, 36-27. Lawrence North Wildcats out in front of the Kokomo Wildcats. And Kokomo being led in scoring by Keith Gaylord, a guy, Tom, we didn't think, from the way he didn't warm up, would even be in this ball game tonight. He has 3 2-pointers and a 3-pointer, and thank goodness for him, or Kokomo might be in real deep trouble right now.
Yeah, he's keeping himself out of traffic where he doesn't get banged around, and the defense gives him a little opportunity, and the pass is on time. He has the ability, of course, to go up and shoot it, and I know it's not an easy effort for him to get up off the floor tonight.
And I don't think he's hurt him very much defensively either. Let's now meet the other two teams that were here today. Here's Scott Gregg.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we direct your attention to the south side of the court for the presentation of awards to the two state finalist teams eliminated this afternoon. Presenting state finalist medals to members of South Bend St. Joseph's High School will be Elmer Stratman of Woodland High School and James Fulford of Owen Valley High School, members of the Indiana High School Athletic Association Executive Committee. First to Darren Teamer. Rodney Holmes. Mike Connaughton. Tom Corcoran. Brett Ballator. Jay Detley. Ken Paul. Rich Kelly. Jamie Jameson. Jim Kosakiewicz. Kevin Wharton. Tom Cavender. Manager Darren Kozarowski. Manager Paul Larkin. Manager John Larkin.
Where? Right here?
Manager Joe Germano.
Start right here?
Assistant coach Jerome Calderon.
Nice season.
Thank you very much.
Assistant coach Paul Minnie.
Thank you.
Assistant coach Dennis Zepka. Head coach Steve Austin. Athletic director Phil Teagarden. And principal Glenn Rousey. And now, ladies and gentlemen, presenting medals to members of Floyd Central will be Joe LaGrange of Perry Central and Charles Hurley of Jennings County, members of the IHSAA Executive Committee. First, C.J. Jackson. Mike Anser. Dwayne McCoy. Roger Reynolds. James Tomes. Jason Kimmelgore. Todd Howard. Chris Miller. Dugan Ryan.
Last one, man.
Pat Graham. Shane Gibson. Sean Gibson. Assistant coach Louis Jensen. Assistant coach Blaine Dust. Athletic director Les Wright.
Congratulations, sir.
Head coach Joe Hinton. And principal Don Sockel. Ladies and gentlemen, let's have a big round of applause for South Bend St. Joseph's and Floyd Central state finalists for 1989.
First medals to those two fine ball clubs. Now let's pause for this from one of your network sponsors, Farm Bureau Insurance. We suggested before the game started, we weren't sure how much Gaylord would play for the Kokomo Wildcats. Keith had had an injury earlier in the day. He did play. Thank goodness, I'm sure Kokomo is saying, because he's the top scorer with 9 points in the first half.
Well, there's a three-pointer from behind the line for the senior.
great shooter. And certainly in this final ball game of senior year, you're going to get out there if there's any opportunity at all.
And, of course, Todd Leary's had a good first half for the Lawrence North Wildcats. He came up with 8 points, including a three-pointer that got them in that lead.
Here's a jump shot by Leary. He has great release, gets high, extends his arms well. Ball right off the fingertips.
Halftime score, 36-27, Lawrence North. Now this from one of your network sponsors, Indiana Bell. Kokomo has never led in this ball game. Lawrence North has been ahead by as many as 10. Those are the halftime numbers right there, 36-27. Here are the first half statistics. Tom Hedgen, let's take a look at these and see what they tell us.
Well, Lawrence North, 65% shooting from the field tells you a lot. That's a phenomenal statistic. Of the 20 shots they've taken, Montross and Leary have taken 15 of them. Kokomo has not been to the free throw line yet. The rebound's pretty one-sided.
And look at the free throw there. That's really a factor in the game because that's the 9-point difference of the scoreboard right now. Stay with us. We have to check the individual scoring here. Montross with 14. Nobody in serious foul trouble, and that's good news, I'm sure, for both coaches. And for Kokomo, Gaylord off the bench with the 9 points. All right, the second half is about set to go. We'll be back with Lawrence North trying to protect that 9-point lead. Now this from one of your network sponsors, American Dairy Association of Indiana. Kokomo High is a school with great tradition. We mentioned earlier their 33rd trip to the Sweet 16, 13th trip to the Final Eight, 7th time in the Final Four. This is their 5th time to go to the championship game. And they won it all in 61, beating Manual 68-66 in overtime. Joe Platt was the coach then. They went 28-1 that year. They were runners-up in 1925 to Frankfort, 1944 to Evansville-Bossy, and to the Christmas Addicts Tigers in 1959. They've had a couple of Mr. Basketballs in 45 Tom Schwartz and 1959 Jim Rail, who was also the IHSAA medal winner that year. And his son, Tim, plays for the Kokomo Wildcats, his youngest son. Set to begin the second half of play. Directly in front of our broadcasting vantage point, Todd Richards. He will inbounds to Damon Watts, number 13. Eric Montross in the middle. And the starting forwards of Todd Leary and Victor Bush are right back where we started the ball game. Some 16 plus minutes ago.
Ryan Reeves back in playing with 3 fouls for Kokomo. Keith Gaylord not starting in his second half.
Leary way outside. Rebound yanked down hard inside by Brad Siebel. I think Tom Brad's got to get more in this ballgame here in the second half. Bob Frost got a piece of that shot that time by Galloway. Kicks it out of the near wing. Here's Watts. Numbers don't add up, so he just holds up, lets the traffic clear. Here's Richards. Back to Watts again. Now Leary. Double up on Leary. And
Bush and Montross down in the hole there. There's Bush with the basketball and put it in.
They call it a skip pass. We used to get yelled at when we did that in school. They throw it across the entire offense and defense, and that time Bush got himself posted in low that time with Montross clearing out the lane. Got himself a shot.
Well, the defenses play a little different anymore than you can get away with that pass.
That's the biggest lead of the game, by the way, 11 points. They quickly take two off of there with the outside shot by Aaron Baker. Eric down with a half a dozen. Keith Gaynor led Kokomo scoring in the first half with 9. Eric Montross led Lawrence North with 14. Nobody else in double figures. You think the pace might slow down a bit, Tom, in the second half?
I think it will until about a couple minutes to go in this third quarter. I think it's a little difficult to get started in that third period sometime.
Montross walking the basketball. No foul. That's the Kokomo cheering section over there. That's the reason you heard so much noise. They had a good view of Eric's violation. Montross, by the way, officially had 1 block shot in the first half, so he has 68 on the year now. Here's a wet spot on the floor. They'll towel that down to make a substitution. Mark Smith back in the ball game.
Looking across the floor where some of the past coaches of state champions are seated, Jerry, just like to make note that Frank Barnes, who coached Shelbyville in 47 of the state championship, a little under the weather and had a little surgery, and I know some of his friends would like to get a message to Frank.
Wish him well. Former Commissioner Phil Eskew and his family are here today. Brad Siebel having to exert himself a little bit more. He has 8 points in the contest. His average is 10-6, and he had 22 points in the afternoon victory today over Floyd Central. 11-point lead cut down to 7, 38-31. We're just inside. 2 minutes gone in the third period. Richards' penetration had to reshape his shot. Rolls off in the far side, and that's Damon Watts.
Hey, Richards and Leary a little alike. When they start to go someplace, they get there in a hurry.
Foul is called against Kokomo. It'll be on Brad Seabury.
And that's two on him. There's the head coach, Jack Kiefer, of this ball club.
You
can still think back to Tom with me saying to him in a pre-telecast interview, you know, you're one of the favorites to win the state, and I can still see the blood running out of his face when I said that to him.
You should have seen him when I interviewed him just before the game.
Coaches don't like to talk about that, do they?
Yeah, he sure does.
Here's Leary again. Rebounded beautifully and back up and good by Bush. How did he hang on to it? He has seven. The lead goes back to nine. 40-31. Well, the only problem Lawrence North had, not the only problem, but one of the problems they had earlier was trying to survive the Indianapolis sectional and the Indianapolis regional.
Okay, then.
It's like a mini state tournament unto itself.
How does Eric do in two games in one day?
Well, he's playing a half pretty well.
Yeah, he has.
Yeah.
He doesn't seem to bother him a great deal, does he?
One and a half isn't bad, is it?
One and a half is not bad. Well, he's got a good attitude, Lawrence North has. I'm sure Kokomo's does also. Here are the turnovers, and you can see there, still Lawrence North has bigger numbers on this side of the column, yet they still have the bigger numbers on the scoreboard.
Kokomo staying back in the zone, and North may be a little more deliberate, although they're not a club that can do a good job of protecting the basketball. They have to use it to score.
Montross moves the ball in a hurry. They'll get into a two-man game once in a while. Here's Leary again, way off the mark. I'm not sure if it was a pass or a shot.
I think by the look on Leary's face, that was a shot, and Watts happened to be in the right spot.
They go back to the 11-point differential, 42-31, 4 minutes and 30 seconds to play in the third period. And Montross just rejects another one. That's his second block of the day. Boy, that'll make you think twice the next time you come in there.
Yeah, you've beaten a defender and think you're going to get a shot at it, and here comes the big swoop.
Leary again, not this time. And the rebound by Richards came out of nowhere. He'll go to the free throw stripe. The foul is on Kokomo, and I'm not sure that time, Tom, that Matt Johnson even had any idea there was anybody around him.
Here's the block at the other end of the floor that Montross put back in the play for North. Here's Keith Gaylor's picture right there. He's come back in the ball game, and Matt Johnson goes out, and Richards will be the free throw shooter.
Richards was 2 out of 4 in the afternoon victory. He has 5 points so far in this game. And he is 3 out of 4 from the strike.
Well, a little off target on that one as it fell to the left.
We had one up earlier today that did that. Half a dozen points now for Todd. Biggest lead of the game at a dozen points. Still Kokomo looking for its first lead of the contest. They got a long way to go just to catch up, let alone grab a lead. Kokomo, preseason rated number 2 by the Associated Press, 3rd by UPI. They finished up 15th by AP and 14th in the UPI rankings. Smith. Nothing doing. Rebound for back up and good by Brad Seabury.
Yeah, good effort by Seabury. Seabury kind of burrowed himself in over there opposite the ball and had a nice spot if it did miss, which it did.
Intercepted by Smith. Now let's see if Kokomo can put some hoops together here. They need to string something out. 3.5 minutes to go in the third quarter. Inside to Smith, working on Montross, gets double team help, missed the shot. Eric shot the rebound. He run to the outlet, passed it, was nobody there. Damon Watts on the near side. Richards.
Well, Kokomo, a good defensive club. We've sung that praise before, but I think sometimes Lawrence North's defense is a little bit underrated, and I think that's one of the factors right now that's caused Kokomo some problems.
Good shot that time by Todd Richards, and now Kokomo's got the basketball again. The basketball not gathers a foul out prior to the shot, and it'll be on Damon Watts. And that's the first in the contest on Damon. Very few fouls called in this ball game. That is only the third on the entire game on Lawrence North. First one of the second half. Lawrence North in that man-to-man little wrestling match going on inside, and they will tag Victor Bush with his second foul. The second in the second half against the Wildcats of Lawrence North High School. So with 2 minutes and 56 seconds to play in this third quarter, there's a timeout taken. It's a 10-point lead for Lawrence North, 43-33. Let's pause now for this from one of your network sponsors, Farm Bureau Insurance. Well, it all began about a month ago, and here's how Kokomo got here. They won their Kokomo sectional, moved on to the Anderson Regional, always a tough one, picked up a couple of victories there. Then to the Lafayette Semi-State. And then earlier today, knocking off Floyd Central, one of the top-ranked teams in the state, 73-70. We're back to live action as Eric Baker picks up his 8th point of the championship game and cuts the lead to 43-35. And a walking violation on Lawrence Fourth. And there's a good, strong full-court pressure defense by Kokomo.
Excellent point, Jerry. They've picked up the tempo of their defense again and also their offense.
You know, Tom and I were talking before the game. We really kind of thought Kokomo might drop this thing down a gear and go in almost in slow motion. Tom, they've not even given that a consideration.
Well, they haven't had an opportunity to after they got behind. They have to move that offense right along.
Sebring. They'll set the offense up one more time. Well, they've got Brian Reeves back in this lineup. I think almost got to have him in there. Here's the steal by Damon Watts. It's a 2-on-2, and Watts had it blocked away by Sebring. It'll belong to Lawrence North on a super play by Brad Sebring, a junior, 6 feet tall. Watch him from the point of the steal.
Now Watts gets in front of Sebring right there to make the steal. Now he's going to try and beat Reeves. And here comes Sebring. Look what he does with it. Reeves finally knocked it out of bounds.
Back to live action and a personal foul called against Kokomo's Keith Gaylord. The first on Keith. And we'll send the big guy to the free throw line.
Kokomo's number 22, Keith Gaylord.
At this point of the game, Montross has 14 points, though none have come in the third quarter. He has 8 rebounds and officially now 4 block shots. He is 5 for 5 from the field goal area. Leary missing. Montross couldn't get it. Neither could Richards. And now it comes to Kokomo. Wildcats cut the lead. They're up down 43-35. The three is short. And the rebound taken down by Sebring. Put back up, deflected by Montross. Stripped away and last touch by the Wildcats.
Well, I think Kokomo might have gotten a call right there. I thought the ball looked like it got away from Montross. But Lawrence North is going to be given the possession.
That is the 5th block shot of the game by Eric Montross. 2:13 to play, third quarter, 43-35. Lawrence North from the Marion County area, just northeast of Indianapolis. Almost considered an Indianapolis school, to be perfectly honest for you. There's the rebound differential, thanks in a great deal to Eric Montross. Out in Lawrence Township. Boy, Montross is busy in the middle, isn't he, Tom?
Yeah, he's learned to play this game pretty well.
Never seems to just find himself a spot and stay there. Leary. Todd Leary getting his first bucket in the second half. He now joins Montross in double figures. He has 10.
Well, North had a 9-point lead at halftime, and we're moving into the last minute and a half of this third quarter, and they've upped that by 1.
Montross changed the shot that time of Keith Gaylor. Gaylor goes for the rebound, and Eric strips it away from him. Now it's 1-on-1. This is Leary going in and over and around Brian Reeves.
Leary has such good judgment when he moves on a drive like that as to whether to take it around the man outside, come back in, or stop for the jumper. He seems to have a great sense of what he's going to be doing right there.
Inside a minute in the third period.
Judgment is almost as good as his talent.
Yeah, great feel for the game.
That's just the biggest lead of the ball game, by the way, guys. His 12-point differential now. Nice spin move inside. Out of bounds. It may have gone off the head. Nope. Last touch by Kokomo. Brad Sebring, who reached in and grabbed it away from Montross. So the Wildcats with inbounds with 40 seconds to play in the third quarter. If you think they're going to hold it, they might. But as Tom pointed out earlier, they won't wait for a 2-second shot. If they get something open with 15 seconds to go, they let it rip.
We'll play for the last shot, maybe not in the period.
Saw Richards. Now they bring Montross way out high just to help handle the basketball. Richards got 3, double clutched it, threw up almost an air ball. It comes down into the hands of Victor Bush. He'll go to the line, he gets the hoop. This is a ball club. I'm telling you right now, Tom Hetchin, Lawrence North is destined to win the state championship.
Todd Richards got that pass in the lane, kind of startled him there for a moment. No one between he and the basket. Then he took off inside, got the shot, and look at Victor Bush there for the rebound. And he's fouled by Mark Smith. Bush will go to the line. Well, up to this point, we have just seconds over a quarter to play. Jack Kiefer has done what most coaches think all year. This is what we want to do, peak at the right time. This ball club is playing as well as they've played all year.
Every button he has pushed has come up big winner. Montross with that rebound again, and that's the end of three quarters. We are 8 minutes away from crowning a high school basketball champion in Indiana. And through three quarters, it's Lawrence North 49 and Kokomo 35. Well, the statistics after three, Lawrence North cooled off a little bit from the field. Kokomo still having difficulty putting it in the basket, only 37%. Kokomo has not been to the free throw line yet. The rebounding margin continues to widen. And that's about it.
Well, Lawrence North has only committed four fouls in the entire game. Two in the first half and two in the second half. So you don't get to the line until you get to the fifth unless you're shooting. So they may never get there tonight. Final 8 minutes of the ball game. Lawrence North out in front, and really, unless something dramatic happens in a hurry, on their way to their first ever state championship. Now they get the roll from Keith Gaynor. Gaynor had a great second period with 9 points, including the three-pointer, but he was shut out in periods one and three. Now the pressure, and I would expect that's what we're going to see from Kokomo, because that's what really brung them to the dance, so to speak.
Well, I know they're not going to fold. Kokomo's going to play them tough. But right now, playing them tough is not quite good enough the way North is going. And Galloway fouls Montross. That's his third.
There's the big guy, Bob Galloway. Lawrence North failed to get out of the sectional last year. But they had three returning starters, and Seb Gurnell moved in from Maryland. When that happened, that gave them a nucleus. And then, about midway through the year, head coach Jack Kiefer sat down with Eric Montross and said, "Big fella, you're going to have to take over the basketball team. You're going to have to be more aggressive. You're going to have to demand the basketball." Because, Tom, what he was doing was working on his assists, trying to make everybody happy. That wasn't working. He didn't play very well in the county tournament, but from that point on, it all seemed to fall in place.
Well, they lost to Warren Central, a pretty good ball club here in the local area during the county tournament, but after that, I think they lost to Pike at the end of the season. That was it.
Well, a three-pointer at the buzzer. They lost a couple other ball games. Cedar Grove beat them, and Marion, the number one team in the state, beat them. Those are their four losses, and they're 24-4 coming into this championship. They're going to back off and give Galloway the outside shot. He won't take it. Seabree does and hits. Randolph with a dozen. His average is 10-6. He had 22 points and a couple of rebounds in the afternoon's victory today. Kokomo's win over Floyd Central. The ball club many thought would be in this championship game tonight. Very off balance, and a blocking foul called against Kokomo. And that is right in front of the Kokomo cheering section, so obviously they are not in total agreement. Blocking foul.
See it right here, and he does everything he can to try and avoid the contact, but I'm afraid that Leary initiated that contact.
It looked a little strange, didn't it?
Yes, it did.
Leary's a three-year starter, excellent free throw shooter. Todd set a new school record this year, hitting 90% during the regular season.
The one thing he was able to do, which I'm sure gave him the call, is he can change his direction very quickly, although looks still like a charge. It wasn't just straight into the man. That was good enough for the official to make his decision in his favor.
Leary had 4 three-pointers in the afternoon victory, by the way, and that is a new high school tournament record.
Hit a mile with the bathroom.
52-39. Lawrence North in green, and in the money, the green money right now. Montross takes it out of there again, and over the shoulder is Galloway. And that should be five on Bob Galloway.
Well, they had Mark Smith over at the bench to put in for him to get him a little rest with the foul load he was carrying, but they couldn't get him in time.
Take a couple of looks at this foul that will get Galloway out of the lineup.
There's Baker's shot that looked pretty good, but came out. There's Galloway, obviously, up and over the back. And the big man's going to the bench with five. He's a 6'8 senior. And meant a lot to Kokomo in the last half of this season.
Well, they're going to miss Galloway. He's spent a lot of time in trouble here. He's a very quick and agile player for 6'8". He had 34 block shots coming into this game. But, boy, it's a tough way to go trying to spend 32 minutes battling this particular giant on the line. Montross, in tournament play, in 7 games, scored 160 points and pulled down 91 rebounds. That does not include his afternoon game.
Matt Johnson will come in at the next opportunity for Kokomo. Montross missing the second shot. Kokomo with it. 6.5 minutes to go. A steal. Richards has it. Todd on the left side. Waits for the traffic to catch up. Watts. Rebound Richards.
Well, Richards is everywhere, isn't he?
Yeah, he kicked it away off his foot out of bounds. Now the substitution for the Kokomo Wildcats.
For Kokomo, and
Johnson coming back in the lineup.
Gaylor's going out. They just have to get someone a little more mobile in the ball game now. Gaylor did a fine job basically on one leg this evening.
Yeah, he has that left knee and a big brace. Give him credit, give him A for effort because he did work hard. 2 minutes gone in the fourth period. 53-39. Lawrence North. Another steal. Yes. Loose ball on the floor. That's Richards diving in with the wrestling match going on with Brian Reeves. Hell ball belongs to Lawrence North.
Yeah, you really, unless you're seeing and going against it on the floor, cannot appreciate the quickness from North. Damon Watts just anticipated that pass wonderfully well and had his inside hand and arm right up in front where you want it as a defender and knocked it away and got the held ball.
Well, they're a little fancy that time. Leary trying to make the move with the hoop, draw the defender outside and drop it off to Montross, and they have some conversations. They head back up court. Friendly conversation, you understand. Because right now, they're in the driver's seat. They're 5.5 minutes away from the first ever state championship unless Kokomo really gets on a rip here. That will count and a foul. Eric Baker up and over Montross. That'll be the second personal foul on Montross.
Well, I continue to be impressed by the way Eric Baker can leap. Watch him go up so easily right here, and he's high when he can get that ball up and over Montross like that. But it really has not been a very good offensive tournament for Baker.
At the free throw line, Eric Baker with one shot.
Here is Eric Baker at the free throw stripe for the first time. And they missed it, but they did not capitalize on the opportunity, and the rebound comes long to Watts. 5'11 junior guard, quietly getting the job done at 13 points earlier today, has 6 in tonight's championship game. Nice move by Leary, got completely around the defensive boy by Reeves, missed the shot though, and the rebound comes to the Wildcats. 5 minutes to play, 53-41, not an insurmountable lead, but things better happen in a hurry for the Wildcats at Kokomo High. Probably cannot see it on the screen, but the jerseys are soaking wet. It's really a warm night in the big city.
For the heat, though, and the type of contest each club played this afternoon, I think that they're really showing great stamina and endurance out here this evening.
So no ill effects from the afternoon games, which are not easy ones, regardless of the final score. Montross wants the jam, won't get it. Personal foul. And Mark Smith, 3 on him. Montross has already sent one big guy, Bob Galloway, to the sidelines for personal fouls. Now he has 3 on his backup, Mark Smith.
Well, Mark Smith gets up and gets a piece of the ball and a piece of Montross there. Look at that big hand catching. He's going for the jam right here, but Smith gets him from behind, and Montross will shoot a pair.
Montross now with 14 rebounds, by the way. Eric had 21 points and 19 rebounds in the victory over South Bend St. Joseph's. Eric's going to have to work on his free throw shooting, Tom. That's the only deficiency I've discovered today.
Well, he's not consistent in his movement at the line, his mechanics. Sometimes he follows through well. Other times he releases very quickly.
He picks up another point. He does not have a field goal in the second half. He has 17 points to go along with the rebound totals we just gave you. 5 block shots in the contest, and he has been an intimidator even when he hasn't been around the ball. There's the 3 by Brian Reeves. Reeves have 5 points. That's the first time he has scored since the opening 8-minute session. Halfway through the final period, and lob it to Leary. Leary gets the hoop.
Well, Kokomo determined to get a comeback here with a 3-pointer. Good defense, they threw long, and what Leary does with the basketball, at least here today, has been magical.
Now lob the three at the other end. Off the mark. Nice rebound inside and a good putback that time by Smith to no avail, though. Montross kicks it out. Here's Watts. Stolen away. Brian Reeves comes out with it. Reeves penetration. Richards fouled him.
Well, Lawrence North a little careless with the basketball at the other end that time, and Brian Reeves comes back, and he knows the circumstances here with 3.5 minutes to go, and they're down by 12. He has to make things happen. The Learys can't touch the ball. He's been out of bounds. He can't come back in and pick it up, and he's trying to stay away from it. And Brian Reeves went to the opposite end. They're not in the bonus yet.
That's right. Thought they're not there yet, so no shots are involved. 3.5 minutes, 3:32 to play. 56-44, 12-point lead for Lawrence North. They've never trailed in this game. They've been ahead by as many as 14 points. They were up 36-27 at halftime, 49-35 after three, and now it's 56-44. North still in that man-to-man. Missing, put back again, off the mark, but a foul.
Montross is going to be whistled again.
Number three on him.
Brian Reeves continues to show his leadership ability and his tenacity out there, even though he's having a little difficulty getting a field goal.
His third. And the free throw line for Kokomo.
There's a first shot attempt, and that's the one, I guess, the second one in which the foul was committed, and two shots coming for Reeves.
Ryan at the stripe for the first time in the ball game. 18 points in the semi-state. Basil Mobby says he's the best point guard I've ever seen. Calls him a second coach on the floor. Three-year starter, captain, all-star candidate. Also a member of the baseball and the tennis squads at Kokomo High School.
Well, if he hits this free throw, they're going to clamp the press on real well. Well, he didn't do it, so North gets a little breathing room to bring it down court.
A little surprised Kokomo went clear back on defense that time.
Well, they were set to put the pressure on a made free throw, and they just dropped back on the missed one.
They lob it over the head of Smith, and Montross gets his first second-half field goal, and it's 58-45 with under 3 minutes to play in the contest. And a timeout by Kokomo. 2:44 to go, 58-45. Lawrence North leads the Wildcats of Kokomo High. Now this from one of your network sponsors, American Dairy Association of Indiana. Well, Tom Heston, when you got a big guy on your team, you can make assists like this. This is Leary.
Now the pass doesn't have to be quite as precise, does it?
No, it doesn't. Anywhere in the general vicinity. Well, he is something. And he's only a junior. 7 feet, 1.5 inch. They have him officially at 7 feet tall, but Jack Keeper, the coach, said, "Now we measured him in sectional time. He's a half inch over that now." And he's still growing, I suppose. Here are the field goal percentages in the ball game. And Kokomo just not shooting well at all. In fact, Tom, they've been in a 30 percentile area since the outset of the game.
Yeah, they started with a tough evening and haven't really improved upon it.
Nice hook pass, shift shot inside. Seabury got the missed shot, and the foul is on Damon Watts. Two on him. You know, I got a feeling, Tom, that Lawrence North is willing to pack their defense in a little deep and let them come in, because the only way in the world that I can see Kokomo catching Lawrence North now is with the three-point bomb. And they're showing no indications of even being interested in that.
They're going to have to utilize the three-point shot. They're going to have the defense on some takeaways, and they're going to need a little help from Lawrence North, too.
Yeah, and maybe some help.
And that may not be forthcoming.
Some help somewhere else, I'm afraid. Now, this is a good Kokomo club. Don't misunderstand. This is not the big guys playing the little guys. Lawrence North is a super club, but so is Kokomo. 13 points for Brad. Hilliard, this was Hilliard Gates' first chance to see them play. Now, here's Leary on the breakaway. Well, how many times have we seen that? While you're employing your full-court pressure, they sneak up court. Hilliard, what do you think? This is a legitimate state champion ball club?
Absolutely. Coached magnificently, and quickness probably more than we give him the credit for.
The foul on the rebound on Smith. That's four on him. They're also, and I don't know if it's come through on the TV sets at home or not, this is a very unemotional club. Tom, recall we watched them when they cut down the nets at Hinkle Fieldhouse after the semi-state. They'd never been any further than that, and it was like, ho-hum, we're not quite through with our job yet.
No, but I feel we're going to see a little laugh when this one ends here tonight, because it's going to be kind of a pressure cooker now release that this was their mission.
Well, they deserve it. Montross at the free throw stripe.
Here comes the three-point shooter, Keith Gaylord.
19 points for Eric Montross, 17 rebounds, 5 blocked shots. And I don't think he sat down a lick, has he?
Not in this ball game. He was out for a minute late this afternoon, the final minute of play.
So he's played everything but 1 minute on the state championship. Did the free throw stripe a lot here in the fourth period and not had a great deal of success. Time out.
Brad Seabree.
Seabree again. The young man has picked up his second bucket, his 15th point of the game. With a timeout with a minute 52 to play and a 60-48 lead for the Wildcats of Lawrence North High School. Now let's pause for this from one of your network sponsors, Farm Bureau Insurance. Well, here's how Lawrence North got here. They had a tough Indianapolis sectional. Wins over Chatard, Broad Ripple, and Cathedral. In the regional game, they beat Brabant 57-54 on a three-pointer in the air as the horn was going off. The shot by Todd Richards. Then they won the semi-state in easy fashion. And a win this afternoon, 81-62 over a club, South Bend St. Joseph's, that was ranked number one throughout much of the season and finished up ranked second and third in the polls. 1 minute, 45 seconds to play. It's 60-48. A whistle and a walking violation on Lawrence North. And the biggest problem I would think Jack Keeper has right now, Tom Eschen, is keeping his ball club's attention to the final minute and 42 seconds.
They're going to do that, and they want to try and keep that clock moving. Kokomo valiantly trying to hang in here, and they're going to come down and I'm sure let go from three very quickly.
Super move inside and a foul call. That's the last thing they wanted to have happen. Gurnell with the personal foul as Reeves found himself a split and a seam in the defense and just went right to the hoop.
Yeah, this looks kind of like the parting of the sea right here as Reeves has a clear shot, so they didn't need to take the three. They're going to get a chance to complete that at the free throw line after Gurnell came in and tried to block that shot.
8 points for Bryan after a 15-point afternoon affair. Rebound is off the front of the rim, picked up by Richards, not a Leary. We're down to a minute, 25 seconds to play in this basketball game, and North is fouled right in front of us by Mondo Fowler.
Well, you see Mondo's number there, number 40, you see, in the sculptured hair.
We're going to have yours done that way next year for the telecast.
What number will they use?
I don't know. We'll come up with one between now and then. Well, that man, this will be his 195th win at Lawrence North, his 256th in the career. His career winning percentage is in excess of 66%. He won sectionals in 85, 87, and 89, regionals in 85 and 89, a semi-state in 89, and he's about to win a state championship.
Well, we really haven't heard all year of Todd Leary being one of the outstanding seniors in the state, but he certainly has put himself in that position today, I think, very legitimately.
His average is 20. He had 28 points in the afternoon victory, 20 points in tonight's game so far. I don't know if he'll make the All-Star squad or not, Tom, but as you say, his credentials in the championship game will deserve him that honor. Mondo Fowler hitting his first points of the game, and Mondo got a starting call at a timeout taken again by Kokomo. 1:14 to play. They're down by 10, 62-52. Now this from one of your network sponsors, Indiana Bell. This is Jerry Baker with Hilliard Gates and Tom Heschen. Tom, I guess you go back to the start of the year. Kokomo lost 3 of its first 4, 5 of its first 9. If you'd have asked Basil Bobby then, hey, man, you think you make the state finals, he'd have laughed you right out of the building. But then they won 20 consecutive ball games and moved into the Final Four, where they won earlier today.
Well, that's going to be a foul on Fowler, I believe, reaching across the end line. He evidently didn't. I don't know how you can do that. I thought when you reached across the end line, it was a technical foul. But let's call it a common foul here. See, Richards can move. It's after a made basket. Well, there's the foul. He didn't reach across. I thought he'd gotten Richards the way it was pointed. It was Leary that he fouled.
Yep. Second one on Mondo. And maybe not a bad foul, although Leary's not the guy you want at the free throw line. He's 5 for 5 in the ball game. Four of them here in this final period.
has 21 points now. In fact, he and Montross are the only players that have scored in the fourth period. 5 points for Eric, and the rest up to this young man. Leary gives Lawrence North a 64-52 lead, and the Lawrence North fans behind us, a two-hour ride can begin the celebration. The three in the sky. Rebound pulled down by Seth Grinnell. And he is fouled by Matt Johnson, number two on him. Here are the three-point shooting numbers. They're not really a factor in this ball game. 1 of 9 and 2 of 8. Lawrence North's three-pointer came from Todd Leary in the second quarter.
Well, this afternoon, Lawrence North attempted 14 in their contest and only 9 at this point. Kokomo in their early contest today attempted 9. So they're about on schedule, comparatively speaking.
Seth Grinnell. Four points in the afternoon victory. Another unheralded player, Tom, but he comes off the bench. You don't lose much in your offense or your defense.
Physically, he's a very good kid. And he doesn't have a bad touch either.
With four. And the lead, 66-52. That equals the biggest lead that Lawrence North has had. And the Wildcats are going to be state champions of high school basketball in Indiana. And a foul against Kokomo on Reeves. Number four on Bryant.
Fouls on Bryant Reeves.
The first Marion County state champion since Broad Ripple in 1980.
The first county school
at
ever.
The free line for Lawrence North.
Wonderful being a city school. Bill Smith's ball
one plus one.
Rockets, they won it. Jack Kiefer. Wouldn't you love to know what's going through his mind right now?
Well, he's very emotional. You can tell the way he's sitting there now, looking at Leary there at the line and knowing the time that they've spent on the practice floor and one thing or another. And he has a great deal of feeling and respect for Todd Leary.
He coached the first 4 years of his coaching career at the high school he attended, Oak Hill High School. Then went to Ball State and Indiana State University for his college education. Biggest lead, 68-52. Inside a minute, Montross continues to get him and rips it out. Here is Todd Leary again. And that slap you may have heard was Eric Montross putting those big size 18s down on the floor at Market Square Arena. The three is up. The three is good. Matt Johnson getting his first points of the game and timeout taken by Kokomo. With the score 70-55, Lawrence North. Now this from one of your network sponsors, American Dairy Association of Indiana. Some coaches talk about getting points off of their defense. Here's a great example of it.
Well, he gets the ball away, and of course, Kokomo has to crash the board now. They need points, but they knew where to find Leary, didn't they?
Tim, Rail is in the ballgame now for Kokomo. We are told that is the first time in the history of Indiana high school basketball that a father and a son have played in the state championship game. Jimmy Rail, of course, played for the Kokomo Club in 1959. He was Mr. Basketball that year, for that matter. They'll get a couple of points from Ryan Hayden.
Well, there's a foul, DeJuan Lewis, and Jack Kiefer says we don't want that.
Lawrence Hawks, number 22, DeJuan Lewis.
They're the runner-up in 59 to the Christmas Attucks Tigers. And that was when that Tiger outfit was beating up on everybody. I don't know if Jimmy Rail is in the attendance tonight or not, but his young son is getting a chance to play in a championship game.
There are some similarities. The fact that they defeated a New Albany ball club that afternoon on a final shot, and they defeated a Floyd County ball club this afternoon in Floyd Central.
Lane violation. Somebody got in the lane too soon, so Reeves will have another opportunity. We're getting word that, has he had it yet? We're getting word that he doesn't know it right now, but Jack Kiefer is about to get a bath on the far sideline. That's what we were talking about. You can hear the crowd counting him down. There is a foul on Tim Rayo, number one on him. with 3 seconds to go. This game, to be honest, and in all due respect to Kokomo, Todd, was dominated from the outset by Lawrence North.
Well, they just had that kind of a day. They did it this afternoon, and they're continuing right on through this one.
I didn't think anybody could play a whole lot better than they played earlier today when they won their contest against South Bend St. Joseph's, and I'm not saying that they played better tonight, but they have come close. They've had one great day of high school basketball. Now we'll let the crowd just take you right down the final 3 seconds. Tom Hession has been pinned up, I suppose, maybe for an entire year. You could almost go back to a year ago, sectional time, when they lost, when they didn't think they should have.
Well, there are a lot of ways to look at it. Of course, the thing you strive for is to win this big one. Sometimes you can get carried away to the point that if you don't do it, you're a failure. And I think maybe they were concerned about that, but they certainly got it done in fine fashion.
Final score again. Lawrence North 74, Kokomo 57. Now let's pause for this from one of your network sponsors, Farm Bureau Insurance. Party now underway at Market Square Arena. There is your final score. We'll meet the winning coach, some of the players. We will have the Trester Award winner announced in a couple of minutes. Let's pick up the PA announcer. Are we ready? Yeah, let's go over and pick up Scott Gregg again.
Team members of Kokomo High School by Forest Road of Portage High School and Emily Stottman of Woodland High School, members of the Indiana High School Athletic Association Executive Committee. Presenting first to Brian Reeves. Mark Merle. Keith Gaylord. Rail. Matt Johnson. Brad Seabury. Mondo Fowler.
37.
No, I'm not going to.
Eric Baker. Brad Bartman. Mark Smith. Mo Watkins. Bob Galloway. Assistant coach Phil Cox. Assistant coach Charlie Hall. Athletic director Jim Killane. Head coach Basil Bobby. Principal Frank Moore.
Scoot down a little so they have some room.
And recognizing also assistant coach Jim Best and assistant coach Alan Cox.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, to present the runner-up trophy to the Kokomo Wildcats.
Let's go on to the floor now. Hilliard Gates has Basil Mommy with him. Hilliard?
Basil Mommy, a great try.
Ladies and gentlemen, you have team 89.
We're disappointed. We didn't play as well as we could, but they're a great team. Eric Montross is very hard to defend, and then they have a great supporting cast. They played very well. So very proud of our team. They gave it all they had, and we came out a little injured, and then we got back in there, but we couldn't get over the hump. They were too good.
You tried a lot of different things tonight.
Well, we tried everything we had, but the ball wouldn't fall in. That's one thing. We go 17 shots the first quarter and only hit six, and you have to shoot better than that. We got a little anxious, but they were a great team, and it's been a great year to win 20 in a row after a 4-5 start. To
21, I think.
21 in a row. I forgot this morning, but to come that far, these kids can really be congratulated. And they are really a great group of young men, and I'm really proud of them.
Well, congratulations to you.
It was a fine year. Job. Congratulations to Lawrence Starr. Thank you.
Okay, back to you, Jerry.
He's a class man. That's Basil Mauby, whose career record is now is in 19 years, 314 wins, 142 losses. And the Lawrence North Wildcats will now take the stand. Eric Montross, by the way, had 19 points today. He was 6-for-6 in field goals, 7-11 free throws, 19 points, 18 rebounds. He had 5 block shots. Tom, that is a career for some players.
Well, he's a very impressive young man on the basketball court. There's no doubt about it. You're attracted to him right away with the size, but the size combined with a lot of other factors really makes him outstanding.
Now let's go back and get Scott Gregg's introduction of the state champion Lawrence North Wildcats.
Executive Committee presenting the state championship medals to Lawrence North. First, Carl Rainey. Damon Watts. Todd Richards. Dewan Lewis. Leary. James Long. Keith Berryhill. Ryan Hayden. Victor Bush. Vince Davidson. Eric Montross.
Here comes the championship trophy now to the Lawrence North Wildcats. Principal Bill McCauley, by the way, is retiring at the end of this school year, so what a great way to go out. We'll get a comment with head coach Jack Keeper, Hilliard Gates, in just a moment here.
buddy with the coach? Give us a wave over here. North Wildcats now 25 wins and 4 defeats. They had a marvelous season this year. And many in the area thought that the team that got out of the Indianapolis sectional had a legitimate chance to go to the state championship. Indeed, that has happened. Let's go out to Hilliard Gates now.
Get a picture?
It's pandemonium here. This is a local group taking over the state basketball. First time since Broad Ripple in 1980 from the greater Indianapolis area. This has been as big a demonstration that I've seen out here on the court at this stage. And now we're going to clear the podium for the presentation of the Trester Award, and then we'll talk to Jack.
All right, Eric Montross is on the podium now with his teammates.
At this time, ladies and gentlemen.
And now we're going to get the presentation of the Trester Award, one of the most coveted awards in all of high school basketball. Again, Scott Gray.
Mr. Charles Hurley for presentation of the Mental Attitude Award.
Each year, the Indiana High School Athletic Association presents a Mental Attitude Award in boys basketball. Farm Bureau Insurance exclusive corporate sponsor also gives a scholarship to the recipient school in the name of the recipient. Before we give this award, I would like for the parents, when the recipient's name is announced, to come down here to the platform to share this moment with your son. The recipient of this award, while a student in grade 12, was nominated by the principal and coach, excelled in mental attitude, athletic ability, scholarship, and leadership during the 4 years of high school. He also participated as a state finalist in this sport and was selected by members of the IHSAA Executive Committee. The 1989 Arthur L. Trester Mental Attitude Award, boys basketball, Pat Graham Floyd Center.
Pat Graham, Floyd Central, had 37 points in the Floyd Central loss to Kokomo earlier today. He was the number one scorer in the state of Indiana. He's a member of the National Honor Society, volunteers his time during the summer to assist in the elementary basketball program for boys and girls, and he will be continuing his education at Indiana University. He has now taken the platform, and we'll be going to the platform to Hilliard Gates in a moment to get a comment or two from this fine young man. What's on this? Even though I'm sure he'd rather have a championship ring and a championship trophy, this is quite an honor for this young man.
Well, it certainly is. And, of course, in Indiana high school basketball, from an individual point of view, Mr. Basketball and the Trester Award are the two highest. And I suppose he's still got a chance to get the grand sweep here this year.
Hilliard Gates has climbed the platform here at Market Square Arena, being surrounded by the media. And let's go out to him now.
Savoring this moment, the parents of Patrick Graham. We'd like to get you on television live around the Midwest. Patrick, congratulations. Icing on the cake. You've had a tremendous career, but this is the greatest individual girl I think you've had.
Well, I'm stunned. I mean, I didn't expect this, and it's a great honor, and I just want to thank everyone, and especially my mother and father.
Well, I know you're an outstanding student. What is your major?
I'm undecided right now, probably either business or criminology.
You're going out to Indiana University on a basketball scholarship.
Yes, sir.
And you'll be playing under Bob Dunn. I know you're really looking forward to that because he recruited you quite some time ago.
Well, you know, he's a great coach, and I've admired him for a long time, and it's been a dream to play for the man, and you know, I'm looking forward to it very much.
If you work consistently throughout all of your younger days and the shooting techniques that you have, you probably are fundamentally as sound as any youngster I've seen shooting a basketball.
Well, that's just you know, practice, and I have to thank my two coaches, Blaine Dust and Joe Enton, for that. You know, they worked awful hard with me, and with all of my game, not just my shot.
Well, congratulations, young man, and continue a brilliant career down at Bloomington.
Thank you very much.
I'd like to talk to the parents of this wonderful young man. What is your name, please?
Carolyn Graham.
And tell me your feelings at this moment.
Well, I'm elated. It's just a great honor, but Pat has worked awfully hard since he was in the fourth grade. I'll have to admit, he really has, but it's great. It's just wonderful.
Congratulations. Mr. Graham, did you play basketball?
Not really. Not really.
Okay. Well, we're running out of time. Congratulations to you. Back to Jerry.
All right, thank you, Hilliard. Final score was Lawrence North 74, Kokomo 57. We'll be back to wrap up and enjoy the final couple of moments of festivities here at Market Square Arena in just a moment. Now this from one of your network sponsors, Indiana Bell.
Jack Pander, this is a great thrill for you. Toiled intelligently and with great talent at Lawrence North, and your feelings at this moment.
I'm just so excited. You know, after we subbed in and got everybody out, I turned to them and I said, guys, you're state champs. And they kind of looked at me and said, you're right. it doesn't hit you quite until it's over with.
You had a little bit of a feeling on the 7:30 telecast that we had. You were talking about this moment, how you look forward all your coaching career to this moment. I think you had a little bit of a feeling.
Well, I felt good about it. I knew we are just simply a taller team, and when you play two games in one day, you take a 6-foot forward like Seabury or something, you don't quite jump as high that second time as you do that first time. And I just felt that we had a lot of things going for us, and I know Kokomo had the one guard, Gilbert or whatever his name was there. He had a bad knee, and that hurt him. He still scored enough, but they had a couple of injuries there. I know it set him back a little bit.
Todd Leary is a great compliment to your team as well as your brilliant center.
Oh, Todd is just – Todd, I don't know. I pick up the morning paper, and I see the UPI doesn't even name him in the top three All-State players. I think I've got a better guard than that out there. He is the guard of the area right now.
Congratulations to you. Savor it, young man. You deserve it. You work very, very hard.
Thank you.
All right. Back to you, Jerry.
All right. Head coach Jack Kiefer of the Lawrence North Wildcats. We had some team statistics. I don't know that they're really significant right now because it was really all Lawrence North in this contest, Tom Heschen. They were led in scoring by Todd Leary with 26. Eric Montross, we gave you his numbers. He had 19 points. He had a marvelous game today. Those two guys put together two super games today.
Well, we had four ball clubs here that had fine aggregations, but we had one ball club that put together the skills at all the positions and wind up having a great day to be the state champions for 1989.
Well, congratulations to the Wildcats of Lawrence North, their fans, supporters, and their faculty, and all the other folks involved with that great school. 74-57, they win it. For Tom Heschen, Hilliard Gates, I'm Jerry Baker. So long from Market Square Arena.
This Indiana High School Athletic Association championship event was brought to you by Indiana Bell, a member of the Ameritech family of companies. American Dairy Association of Indiana, your local dairy farmer. And by Farm Bureau Insurance, proud corporate sponsor of all IHSAA tournament events.